manifestations of two diametrically opposite lives. The outer invisible, or show, sensed by everyone around them, and the inner and hidden, only ordinary beings there, especially the people wearing masks, are entirely incapable of perceiving the words in their outer, invisible manifestations. These poisony nosferian monks appear to be what your favorites would describe as bigots of the degree, and in their secret inner manifestations, hidden from others, what your favorites would call expert cynics, also of the highest rank. As for why the involutionary process of the exuary, I'm uncertain of the abstaining monk's choices of sensorian vibrations. Instead of the closets of fact, there even exists a very detailed theory, worked out several centuries ago by a certain Buddhist monk. However, the monk proved conclusively that this happens because in the first years of their existence, these thin monks busy themselves very zealously with that occupation from which, as is known even to contemporary medicine, pimples generally appear on the faces of young beings there. Represent to yourself and fully understand the significance of this sort of abstinence among these contemporary monks. It remains for me to add that during my last sojourn on the planet Earth, I became convinced that, thanks only to the results of the involutionary process of the exuary in these unfortunate terrestrial abstaining monks, the crystallization of various consequences of the properties of the organ tundra buffer in their common presence has become greatly facilitated and has therefore increased. Beelzebub was interrupted by a ship's servant who handed him a Lady Jambrose. He put it to his ear and began to listen to the contents. Chapter 40. Beelzebub tells how men learned and again forgot about the fundamental cosmic law of Heptaparaparshino. After Beelzebub had listened to the contents of the Lady Jambrose handed to him, his grandson Tassane again turned to him and said, "Dear and kind grandfather, please help me clear up one contradiction which I do not understand and which does not accord with my logical confrontations." When you began your elucidations concerning the holy planet Purgatory, you enjoined me to try to take in everything you told me, without missing anything, and you also enjoined me to maintain without ceasing the intensity of my active mentation, so the corresponding data for a clear representation of all these details, both fundamental sacred cosmic laws, should be completely crystallized in me. I did indeed try during all your elucidations to do so, and it seems to me, I cleared up so much of myself about these cosmic laws that perhaps I could even freely explain them to someone else. In any case, I can already represent to myself very well the sacred law of Priamesopondo, the particularities of all three of its independent sacred forces, and recognize it for my own essence quite satisfactorily. And in regard to the sacred law of Heptaparaparshino, although certain of its details, unimportant in my opinion, are still not entirely clear to my reason, I hope that with a little more active pondering I shall understand them as well. However, while trying to assimilate these sacred laws thoroughly, I clearly sense that they are very complicated and that it is difficult to have a complete understanding of them. Then suddenly a question arose in
Having nothing in Thank you.
indicates similar beings around him into this truth. Now, my boy, listen while I tell you how these peculiar three-brained beings first became aware of the fundamental cosmic law of the sacred Heptagon Parchino, and how the totality of information concerning this knowledge possessed by certain beings of ancient times was actualized in all this. Details from generation to generation, thus becoming the inheritance of every subsequent three-brained being of this planet of yours, and listen also to what the strangeness of their psyche has made out of all this. I wish to explain to you in as great detail as possible, in historical sequence, not only how your favorites became aware of this sacred law, but also how they gradually forgot about it. This information would greatly help you to elucidate those unimportant details, as you call them, which you have not yet completely transubstantiated in your recent brother laws. Learn from this that even in our day, among your contemporary favorites, genuinely learned responsible beings who occasionally appear to see partial and modest conscious efforts to generate the rising and gradual development of genuine objective science even on this ill-fated planet, assuming that the other three-brained beings that were to exist more or less normally, and as a result that welfare might also be obtained for them which has long since been merited and enjoyed by the three-brained beings of all other planets of our great mega cosmos. In the beginning, during the period when the three-brained beings of that planet still had in themselves the organ thunderbolt, it was of course out of the question that they could have learned about any cosmic force. But later, when this maleficent organ had been removed from their presence, and when in consequence their psyche became free and, so to speak, individual and their own, it was just then that all the trouble arose for their relatively sane being mentation. Single quote. The first time that these three-brained beings who have taken your fancy perceived and cognized with their whole presence the fundamental cosmic law of the sacred Heptagon Parchino was on the continent of Atlantis when CER. Knowing beings, do you remember, I have already told you, understood by themselves that something, not quite right, proceeded in them, and when they also discovered that they had certain possibilities of destroying this something, not quite right, and of becoming such as they ought to be. It was just at that period in the flow of time when certain of them had observed those abnormal functionings, proceeding in their common presence, abnormal, that is, according to sane being mentation, and were seeking out their causes, and trying to find every possible means to remove them from themselves, that many branches of genuine science reached a very high degree of development among those who were seriously interested in this most essential activity of reason, as it was then called, was a terrestrial three-brained being by the name of Theophany, who was the first to lay a rational foundation for the subsequent development of this branch of genuine science. As I chanced to learn later, this Theophany was once pouring a certain mixture onto a marble slab to dry, which consisted of the extract of the plant then called, he took, pine resin, and freed from the melt of the then payment, pinion and goats, so that when hardened into the grease a mastic used for chewing after eating, when he noticed for the first time that in whatever way and in whatever quantity this mixture was poured onto the marble slab, it always solidified in the same same way, and after the final cooling always assumed a form composed of seven distinct plane surfaces. This fact, unexpectedly ascertained by Theophany, greatly astonished him and an intense which arose in his heart and from his reason the root causes, still unknown to him, of this lock-informable phenomenon, and he therefore began to repeat the same procedure, now with a conscious aim. From the very beginning of the investigations on this, taken by Theophany, his friends, other learned beings with whom he shared the findings of his experiments, also became interested and participated in his further research. Well then, after long and detailed investigations, this group of learned three-brained beings of your planet recognized for the first time and became categorically convinced that almost all the possible results manifested around them were perceived by the ordinary beings in some or other definite form, always having the course of their external transitory state seven independent aspects. As the result of the conscious labors of these older, three-brained beings, a branch of almost modern science arose and began to develop on the continent of planets under the name of Tazalorinono, which meant the science of the seven aspects of every whole phenomenon. But when that continent perished, no trace of this branch of genuine science survived, and again for many long centuries the beings of that planet knew nothing about this sacred cosmic law. This branch of science on the continent of Atlantis was evidently so widely known that the learned beings there saw no need to know anything about it in electromagnetism. As you may remember, they usually live for all those ideas, the knowledge of which they wish to transmit unchanged to beings of future generations. Concerning this branch of science had existed, something of this knowledge would certainly have been preserved, as was the case with other knowledge attained by the beings of Atlantis, through those who were by chance saved. Saved after the loss of that continent. Sacred texts are largely became known again only after many, many of their centuries, thanks to two great terrestrial learned beings, the brothers Chumbotes and Chumbotel, who later be came saints and who are now on the holy planet Purgatory where we have just been. Do you remember? I already told you that on the continent of Asia, the country where Elder Caesar was a king named Coniagin, a descendant of the learned member of the Society of Octans who had gone there from Atlantis for the observation of all kinds of natural phenomena of their planet, and that this same king had invented for his subjects the ingenious tale I told you about in order to save them from the pernicious habit of chewing the seeds of the flower called Wobblian. Well then, the grandson of this king Coniagin, after the arising of an heir to an history became king for the beings of this group, had two results of the male sex, twins, the first of whom was named Chumbotes and the second Chumbotel in the country where Elphi seated her, Chum meant prince, sixth of. These two brothers, direct descendants of one of the chief members of the Great Learned Society, happened on the one hand to meet with corresponding